Today we have two funerals, and while we pray for them as well as those who passed away recently, this week and last week, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower His mercy and forgiveness to them. And I thought it's perhaps the time for us to remind ourselves about the reality of death. Normally, once a year in the Friday Khutba, I talk about this theme. And that's what I want to do today as a reminder for myself and all of you here. We know that death is part of life. From the Islamic perspective, life wouldn't have a meaning unless there is a death and the life hereafter. In Surah Mulk, a surah which is recited normally to those who are in the last stages of their lives, and even for the isal al-sawab and reward of those who pass away, the very early ayat, Tabarak alladhi bayadihi al-mulk wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. Blessed is the one in whose hand is the kingdom, and he has power over everything. And to reflect his power, the very first thing he mentions, Alladhi khalaq al-mawta wa al-hayat. He's the one who created death and life. As I normally talk about this ayat, and I say, look at the sequence. He talks about death first and life later on. Just to emphasize that, you know, for us, death is a reality. And why did he send us to this dunya? لِيَبْلُوكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. So that he may test us to see who among us is a doer of good deeds. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْغَفُورُ. He is powerful on one hand, but also remember that he is forgiving and merciful. One of the names that we have in Islamic literature about death reflects this reality, where we say al-maut is al-yaqeen. Sometimes the word yaqeen is used to describe maut because this is something nobody can deny. Even the atheist and those who do not believe in God, in divinity, in hereafter, still nobody can deny when it comes to the issue of maut. In Surah Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ayat 78, أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت ولو كنتم في بروج مشيدة. He says, wherever you are, there is no escape from death. It will reach to you. Even if you are في بروج مشيدة, very strong towers. Then nobody can stop this process of death. And the mystery of death is that, when will it come? Where will it come? At what age? And at what state? We don't know anything about it. Nobody knows about it. We just have to be ready for it. And this is where, you know, Amir al-Mu'mineen in one of his khutbah, salawat upon the Akbar. He talks about this issue and he says, أُوصِيكُمْ بِذِكْرِ الْمَوْتِ وَإِقْلَالِ الْغَفْلَ عَنْهُ. He says, I advise you to remember death. And I ask you to decrease your heedlessness about death. We ignore. In a way, it's a blessing, because if you think about death every minute, you will die probably easy, closer. But then Amir al-Mu'mineen says, إِقْلَالِ الْغَفْلَ. You know, reduce your heedlessness about death. At least sometimes think about it. And that's where, you know, then he goes on to say, وَكَيْفَ غَفْلَتُكُمْ عَمَّ لَيْسَ يُغْفِلُكُمْ. How can you be heedless about a reality where he is not going to forget you? When the time comes, it will come. وَطَمْعَكُمْ فِي مَا لَيْسَ بِمُهْلِكُكُمْ. And why do you expect the angel of death to give you some more, you know, extension? When the time comes, he will come. فَكَفَى وَاعِذًا لِمَوْتَ آيَنْتُمُوهُ. He says, you know, look around. And this is where sometimes we are told that, you know, it is recommended by itself to go and visit the qubur of the Muslimin, just as a lesson for ourselves, besides the issue of going and reciting Fatiha for them. Because it is a reminder for ourselves. And Amir al-Mu'mineen says, you know, look at those who have passed away. Their death and their passing away is a lesson for ourselves. And he says, remember, حُمِلُوا إِلَىٰ قُبُورِهِمْ غَيْرَ الْعَاكِبِينَ. They were carried to their graves, not riding themselves on a horse or a car. وَأُنزِلُ فِيهِ غَيْرَ نَازِلِينَ. And they were placed inside the grave, not by their own will. كَأَنَّهُمْ لَمْ يَكُونُوا لِلدُّنْيَا عُمَّارًا. It seems as if they never lived in this dunya. This was not their place. وَكَانَ الْآخِرَةُ لَمْ تَزُلْ لَهُمْ دَارًا. And now it seems as if that was their longer, you know, place of abode till the day of Qiyamah. أَوْحَشُوا مَا كَانُوا يُوطِنُونَ. They became strangers to the place they were familiar with it in this dunya. وَكَانَ الْآخِرَةُ لَمْ تَزُلْ لَهُمْ دَارًا. وَعَوْطَنُوا مَا كَانَ يُوحِشُونَ. And now they are at home, a place which was strange to them before. وَاشْتَغَلُوا بِمَا فَارَقُوا وَعَضَاءُ مَا إِلَيْهِ انْتَقَلُوا. Amir al-Mu'minin says, remember, this dunya makes you busy with so many things. Eventually, you leave all those things behind. And so you think about the preparation for where you're going, whether it is barzakh or eventually the akhirah. Salawat. It says, once we reach there, لا أن قبيح يستطيعون انتقالا ولا في حسن يستطيعون ازديادا. Once we are placed in the grave, we can't remove the evil that we had done, and we cannot even increase the good deeds that we have done. This is where, you know, isal sawab and doing charity for marhumin comes in, because now their book, as far as their actions are concerned, is closed. It is those who are left behind. They can still improve the situation of those who have gone away, especially when you are talking about barzakh. أَنِسُ بِالدُّنِيَا فَغَرَّتْهُمْ. Amir al-Mu'minin, in this khutbah number 188, concludes with the last line where he says, they were attached to this world, but the world deceived them. وَوَثِقُوا بِمَا بِهَا فَصَرَعَتْهُمْ. They trusted this dunya, but the dunya abandoned them. And so think about the akhirah. Build the akhirah in this dunya. The dunya is to build our barzakh and our akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to understand the reality of death. In ahsan al-hadith, kitabullah al-aziz, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wa la'asr inna al-insana la fi khusr. إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي لا إله إلا هو الحليم الكريم، غافر الذنب وقابل التوبة وهو الغفور الرحيم. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا هو العتوف للعباد بجوده والعواد على المذنبين بحلمه. ونشهد أن محمدا نبيه وحبيبه. صلوات الله. سيد المرسلين وشفيع المذنبين ورحمة للعالمين صلى الله عليه وآله الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا أوصيكم عباد الله بالتوبة ما سلف من ذنوبكم أمير المؤمنين in that khutbah number 188 continues. He says, remember the death. فَسَابِقُوا رَحِمَكُمُ اللَّهِ إِلَى مَنَاظِرِكُمُ الَّتِي أُمِرْتُ أَن تَعْمَرُوهَا. He says, O people, may Allah have mercy on you. Hasten towards the houses that you have been, commanded to populate. That's our abode in the Akhirah. And we have to go through the process of barzakh. And don't look at this dunya as your, final abode. And prepare for it. Because this is where, you have been asked to go for, look forward for it. وَدُعِيتُمْ إِلَيْهَا. And you have been called towards the Akhirah. وَاسْتَتْمِمُوا نِعْمَ اللَّهَ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالصَّبْرِ عَلَىٰ طَاعَتِهِ وَالْمُجَانِبَةِ لِمَعْصِيَتِهِ. How do we prepare ourselves and build our akhirah in this dunya? He says, seek the completion of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing two things. Number one, sabr and endurance in his obedience. When we do things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to do, it's not always easy. Whether it's the daily salat, timings, or the fasting of Ramadan, or sharing what he has given to us in form of zakat and khums and fitra and other things, or giving in sadaqat. All these things need sabr and patience. And then on the other side, he says, and also exercise abstinence from his disobedience. So sabr in obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and abstinence when it comes to disobedience towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he says, remember, tomorrow is not that far away. Everyone, will face that day one day. And he says, remember, how fast are the hours of the day? These days, life is so fast, we don't even get enough time to what we have planned. And hours just go by. He says, how fast are the days in the month? And how fast are the months in the years? And how fast the years in a life? So the time will just go on. And we have to make sure that we build our akhirah in this dunya. In another statement that he has in a letter that he wrote to the people of Egypt, this is other than the letter that he wrote to Malik Ashtar when he appointed him as the governor of that province. And this is addressed to the people of Egypt where he says, Ya ibadullah, innal maut laysa minhu fawtun. When it comes to death, there is no escape, no running away from it. Fa'adhiruhu qabla wuqu'ihi. Be ready for it before it comes to you. وَعِدُّ لَهُ عُدَّتُهُ. And prepare the provision for it. فَإِنَّكُمْ تَرْضُ الْمَوْتِ. You are going to face that reality. وَإِنَ قَمْتُ لَهُ أَخَذُكُمْ. If you wait for it, it's going to come anyway. If you run for it, from it, it's going to catch up with you. وَهُوَ أَلْزَمُ لَكُمْ مِنْ ظِلِّكُمْ. He says, death is actually closer to you and always with you more than your own shadow. The example he's using, your shadow is with you all the time. He says, maut is actually alzam, is closer to you and attached to you more than your own shadow. And it comes. It comes the way it will come. فَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ الْمَوْتِ عِنْدَمَا تُنَاذِعُكُمْ إِلَيْهِ أَنفُسَكُمْ مِنَ الشَّهَوَاتِ. When we talk about remembering death, this is the main point. Remembering the death for what? He says, remember death when there is a tension within yourself, where you have the desire which is asking you to do something which is against the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, at that time, if you remember death, that will be the most powerful, you know, way of resisting it. وَكَفَى بِالْمَوْتِ وَاعِظًا. He says the phenomenon of death itself is the most effective preacher for you. And then he ends by the statement from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Where he says that the Prophet used to frequently advise his companions to remember death by saying, and this is Ali quoting the Prophet, أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ الْمَوْتِ فَإِنَّهُ هَادِمُ اللَّذَّاتِ. Frequently remember death, because this remembrance of death will eliminate or destroy these desires which are haram. هَائِلٌ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ الشَّهَوَاتِ. This remembrance of death will become a barrier between you and the evil desires that you have. And so when we are talking about the issue of death, it's not only just remembering in that way, but remembering it is a way of keeping us back online to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to stay away from the disobedience. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, bless our marhumeen and give them the place in the proximity of the masumeen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to remember the death in the effective manner of preventing us from committing evil desires. Allahumma salli ala sayyidil mursaleen wa shafi'il mudhunibin nabiyyina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وعلى إمام المتقين وعمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب صلوات الله عليه وعلى سيدة نساء العالمين سيدتنا فاطمة بنت رسول الله صلوات الله عليها وعلى سيد شباب أهل الجنة الحسن المجتبى والحسين الشهيد بكربلاء عليهم الصلاة والسلام وعلى أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي عليهم الصلاة والسلام. اللهم صل على مولانا الحجة بن حسن صاحب العصر والزمان. ما أحيا أثار البدء والطغيان هادم أمنية الشرك والنفاق حاسد فر البغي والشقاق صلوات الله وسلامه عليه ولا آبائه الكرام ما اتصلت الليالي والأيام. اللهم عجل فرج وصح المخرج واكحل ناظرنا بنظرة منا إليه واجعلنا من المستشهدين بين يديه. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يذكر فتنفعه الذكرى. إن الله يعمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. Thank you.